Sis got blah, boy, sis got blah, boy. Yeah. 901 Shelby Drive, look alive, look alive. Niggas came up on this side, now they on the other side.
People's Kid, how we doing? It's your boy Kobe back at it again with another video, and as always, hope you guys are having a blessed day. Man, there is nothing like the month of March with the NCAA tournament and all the crazy games that come along with it. In honor of this time of the year, I thought it'd be fun to go back and talk about a player who I think has kind of been forgotten by just about everyone. Kenny George, the tallest player in the history of college basketball, had a very interesting career, and I thought it was time to show him some love by telling his story. Real quick, just want to thank everyone for the crazy support lately. We're pretty close to 25k, which is awesome. If you guys enjoy the content, as always, make sure to drop a like and subscribe. And with that said, let's jump right into it. When it comes to everyone's childhood goal of making it to the NBA, there is no other sport where height matters more than basketball. Unfortunately, if you ain't got the size or length to play in the league, it probably just isn't going to happen for you. Think about it like this. The average American male is 5'9", and 99% of these American males are under 6'4". So when you consider the average NBA height present day is a ridiculous 6'7", you better have some incredible genes to just give yourself a fighting chance. Even then though, a kid like Bronny Jr., who is profiled all the time as one of the best youth basketball players, is no guarantee to make the league, especially if he doesn't grow to be as big as his dad. What I'm trying to say is, height matters a lot, and it could be the thing in the way of some players getting a chance at both the college and pro level. But with this in mind, is there ever a time where a player could be too tall or too big, and what would that look like? Well, let me introduce you to a player by the name of Kenny George. Providing a brief intro, Kenny was born in 1987 and grew up in Chicago, Illinois. When he was a teenager, doctors noticed he had an overactive pituitary gland. Now, I'm not a doctor, but apparently this condition leads to enormous growth in the body. And by the time George was a sophomore at high school, he was 6'11". Let me repeat, 6'11" at 15 years old. Unbelievable. As wild and crazy as that is, what was even crazier was that Kenny did not play basketball seriously at all until this year. In fact, it wasn't until the varsity basketball coach at Chicago Latin High School noticed how big he was that he demanded Kenny come play for the team. What impressed the coach didn't just include his size though, it was the coordination in which George was able to play with on the court at such an incredible height. So by his senior year at Chicago Latin, Kenny posted averages of 8 points per game, 10 rebounds, and a very impressive 9 blocks per game. By this time, George had grown to become an out-of-this-world 7'7" physical freak. Yet despite his obvious game-changing abilities and world record-threatening height, Kenny did not have many D1 schools calling his name. The reason being was many coaches were not sure if George could handle Division I basketball when it came to his knees. Having also dislocated his knee in his senior season, the possibilities of re-injuring his knees were quite high in comparison to typical players who were not as large as him. However, overlooking the hazards of George's obvious injury risk, Eddie Edenbach of UNC Asheville decided he wanted to give George a shot to play college hoops and offered him a scholarship to play for the school in 2004. While Kenny would not be able to play his freshman year due to academics, the next year would prove to be just as futile as he would need surgery to repair a dislocated knee, also keeping him out for the season. But finally, with 2 years under his belt at the school with no game action, Kenny made his debut at UNC Asheville on November 22, 2006 against Virginia. And after just 15 minutes of game action, George was able to immediately justify the decision Edenbach had made to offer him a scholarship, as Kenny produced 5 blocks in that time span. And while that 15 minutes caused the 7'7", 370-pound George to miss the next 5 games due to the soreness of his knees, Kenny saw more game action as the year went on and finished with 5.5 points per game, 3.5 rebounds per game, and 2 blocks per game in just 10.5 minutes of contest. Although these numbers aren't impressive when looked at independent of context, Kenny's ability to be able to play even marginally this year brought a lot of confidence to George and the UNC Asheville coaching staff, giving them optimism he could take another leap the following season. And in perfect timing for this narrative, it turns out UNC Asheville had every reason to be excited for the 2007-2008 season, as this would be George's breakout year.
tall, and then there's Kenny George tall, actual size. Sort of like there's Rich and then there's Bill Gates Rich. The UNC Asheville Center stands 7 feet 7 inches tall, 7'9" in one of his 12 pair of custom-made Nikes, the only shoes he owns, because nobody else makes a size 28.
Having been able to manage the knee soreness, Kenny was able to play nearly a full 20 minutes per game this year and exploded for averages of 12.4 points per game, 7 rebounds, and 3.3 blocks a contest. If we take a minute just to consider these numbers on a per 40-minute average, Kenny's numbers ballooned to 25.1 points per game, 14.1 rebounds per game, and a ridiculous 6.7 blocks per game. Some of his best moments included a 14.11 rebound performance against Tyler Hansbrough in North Carolina, as well as producing the first triple-double in UNC Asheville history against Campbell University. Despite the memorable Hansbrough dunk had on George that went viral, Kenny's amazing productivity while he was in the game could no longer be ignored by pro scouts, and discussions started to brew on whether George could actually handle the NBA. I mean, sure, he couldn't run the court very well, but in a half-court offense and defensive set, you'd be hard-pressed to find better rim protectors. Just look at some of the footage he had against UNC, and the reality becomes quite clear. Hell, just look at any footage he had, and your mind starts to wonder what he could do. No longer a sideshow, and truly one of the best big men in the country, Kenny and his size 28 feet had one more year to really set himself up for consideration from the NBA. But with such an unorthodox rise, also likely for unexpected turns, horrible news arose for Kenny and UNC Asheville during preseason of the 2008-2009 season. Somehow, Kenny had developed a foot infection in the offseason, and this would lead to doctors having to partially amputate his right foot, completely jeopardizing George's basketball career. And while I wish I could find more details on the story, it did indeed end his UNC Asheville tenure, as he would never play another game for them. But for those who think Kenny's career was completely over, in 2011, I guess, George made an appearance for a professional team in Europe and actually did pretty well, averaging 11.5 points per game on 48% from the field in just 4 games. Since then, Kenny has pretty much shied away from the spotlight and leaves us with his no-jump dunks and ridiculous blocks to remember him by. Although it would have been great to see him in the NBA, I'm just happy George was able to get an opportunity to play while he could, and I wish him the best in whatever he pursues next. Anyways guys, that's the video. Just a quick vid on a guy I remember watching growing up and being amazed at his size and effortless ability to dunk the basketball. Let me hear your guys' thoughts below on Kenny and what you think of him. Do you think he could have made the NBA if he didn't get injured? Would love to hear your opinions. With that said, hope everyone has a great rest of the day, or night, or whenever you're watching this. Hit the like and subscribe button if you can. I'll be back at it soon. Peace out.